So I thought that since I was already in here working, that I could basically do a little live video on bending the sides. So basically I was just about to start, I just started the bending iron. Started on bending the sides. I wanted this one. Okay. So what I'm doing is, you guys might recognize the mandocello form. So I'm at home. I've got stuff already started, but I'm missing some material, so might as well just put that time to use. So I've got some mahogany that I'm going to be using. I've got a mahogany head block, and then a tail block here. And then I've got my points that are made out of spruce because it's lighter and doesn't need the same kind of strength. So I was just going to get started on bending this mahogany side, so I'm going to start with the scroll and make my way around the whole instrument. First of all, I probably want to undo this jig. Side for now, because like the first one that I did, I wanted to start with the scroll. Show you my setup here. As you can see, I've got the bending iron over there that's is starting to heat up, and then I've got my jig that's ready to have the bent scroll first, and then I'm going to clamp it in there, and then I'll be able to continue with the other pieces. So I feel like this is a good spot for the camera. It's just starting to get hot. So to bend this, 9 inches. So I've got some measurements that I put onto my jig that tells me roughly where the bends are going to be. So that's basically where the scroll is going to finish at this location, and then where the waist is going to be. So I like to have those somewhat written down so I can quickly have a visual while bending. Then I need a piece of aluminum paper. Like I mentioned the first, when I did the video, and I'm guessing if you're watching this live feed, you already know what's going to happen. So what I do is I put the foil, and then I
put water in there, and then when the foil is all folded up, the only way the moisture can move somewhere is throughout the exit point, which is going to be here at the back, which creates a lot of heat and moisture in the area that I want to bend. So that's what I'm getting ready for here. And when as soon as the bending iron is warm enough, I'll be able to get started. So if you have any questions, just feel free to put a comment. Make some room. So if you just tuned in, I'm going to be bending a mahogany side. So that's African mahogany. While the bending iron is warming up, I can actually show you. I've got the back here for I'm making another mandocello. So that's a back for, it's not glued yet. I'm just kind of working out where basically I'm going to be putting the actual shape, but that's how it looks. Then I also have very nice red cedar top for it. So that's already glued and ready to start carving.
And also, I've been busy lately, so I got an octave mandolin there. That's an old guitar that I'm kind of redoing the peg head on. And then I've got a mandolin here. So, try to stay busy. Just quickly rounded the size here of this little block that's going to be pushing on the side of the scroll, just so I don't have actually marks from the piece of wood into the side. So that's going to be ready to go. And I've got the side. I don't know if you can see the smoke starting to. Oh, it's getting hot. That's good. So I don't put a lot of water. Like I mentioned earlier, like all the moisture will stay within that foiled paper. All right, let's see.
it's quite hot enough yet. Probably wait another minute. If you have any questions, feel free to put a little comment on there. I'll try to answer them as I'm doing this. Not too sure how long I'm gonna be doing this live thing. I would like to get most of the sides bent, so might be an hour or. So while we're waiting, I can show you as well. I was working on the block earlier to do the fitting. So I was using this blade and I was using it as a file to refine the shape of it. Just instead of using like a hand file and do everything by hand, that's what I was doing. I was doing it. I can show you on this side because I know I've got some to remove. Gives a pretty good finish, ready for the glue up. So once the sides are in, I'm gonna have more refinement to do with this, but I'm getting really close right now. That's in real time. Always look faster when you watch a video. I'm gonna leave it here for a few seconds just so there's actually a lot of warmth that goes through it. Then I'll remove the aluminum paper, then roll it against unless it's cracked or anything. But technically I should be able to just put it back on there and without the foil that helps drying a bit. Then I'll put it in the jig until it basically cools off, so I can finish after that the rest of the bend. That looks good. So you can see the inside is dry, but the outside is still wet. While it's still hot, I'll try to get it in here. Probably not. There's a lot of spring back on this one. Not quite there. So I'm going to let this one dry for a bit. Looks pretty good. There's a start of a split right here, but it's very, very small. Yep. So I'm going to let this one dry for now. So for questions, let's have a look.
Kind of have my
live feed here on the so there's fusion music that's there, so hi, thanks for not being shy. SB Productions asking what the thickness is, so there are 0.1, so 0.1000, so 100, 0.100. And yeah, so I usually keep them on the thicker side when I don't have a lot of figure,
So if I do like a figure maple, I'm gonna go to
0.080 thousand. But this one doesn't have any figure at all. So that gives me a lot of material after the fact to refine. So the next one I want to do is going to be this one here, which is kind of a cutaway that wraps around. So I want to do this one first, and I'm just going to leave it to basically dry on its own, because I need to have my other bender to do the smaller side. So, got 7.5 here. So that's here. I go funny, sometimes I don't even trust myself. I put measurements on the sides and I just want to make sure before I cut it that the measurement is right. I would assume that that measurement was done properly, but who knows, right? This one. Okay, this one, now if you want to bear with me, I need to get the charger for the phone because for some reason it's already at 20%, so if I want to keep this live feed up, I'm going to need my charger, so I'll be right back. Should be good now. Put an extension cord. There we go. So now we've got a charger on the phone, so should be able to last a little longer. Okay, so now I cut this piece. The idea for this piece is that it's gonna go right in here. So I'm gonna basically use the same setup that I just used. Now that's really, really hot, which is good. Just want to double check that I actually put it the right way. And yeah, actually put it the wrong way. And that's out. So yeah. Once that one is bent, I'll get back to the live feed. Looks like I've got a few questions or comments. This should be easy to set as soon as I get this front piece. So I'll just clamp that in here for now. There we go. So that's good for now. So we got Woodbine right here with us. Nice to see ya. Then big guitars and furniture. Is asking, hope you fill the bill. Then actually, is it? Okay, no, that's for another comment. Okay, so we got Keith May that's there, and yeah, so a few people. Thanks for stopping by.
Okay, so far we've got the two biggest bends that are done, or almost done. So this one will still need, I don't know if I can actually get you guys a bit closer so you can see what I'm talking about. So the radius that I just put here is from my big bender, obviously, but this one here is going to need to be on a smaller one, and that one's from a propane torch, so I kind of have to change my setup. So I always do like the big bends first, and then I come back to finish those ones. So what I need to do now is I'll put this one aside as well, because I've got this one that's done, and then I'll get back to the other one. Now it should technically be cold enough so I can work on it again, like the scroll band that's here. So we'll get it out of the mold and try to shape the rest of it. So if you were there from the beginning, the pencil mark that I put are here and here. So this here line tells me that this is the bump here, and the line that I have here shows me that's the other bump that I have there. So it's easier visually for me, and I can actually put a bit more of a, somebody's taking my pencil. So I can remake the mark because they're getting pretty faint from the first bend, and now I also need to remove this. So to remove this, I've got some little butterfly wing nuts underneath. And I'll leave the actual screws in there until I'm done with the bends, but this section that I use to do the scroll, I don't actually need right now to do the other band. So it's going to be here, and then I need a piece of backing. So for those of you who wonder, it's not spring steel. Spring steel tends to get back to its shape on its own, but it's very, very pricey. And I spent most of my life, 22 years of it, doing steel manufacturing. And in the company I was working for, they actually had stainless steel
So that's stainless, so it doesn't leave any marks, doesn't rust, and the only inconvenience is that I have to shape it back to its original shape. But since I didn't actually have to pay for it because they were leftovers from a different job in the steel bin, so I was able to score that. So the first time around, I tried to keep as little pressure. I'm just trying to heat up the surface, get the fibers to start moving on their own. Actually, for this one's gonna be a bit too long. Look at the other one. I've got different lengths and shapes and stuff, so. Go a bit more in. Hey Matt, how's it going? Hey James, are you gonna do your 12 string all by hand tools, or how's that gonna work? I actually did a mandolin all hand tool one. It takes a lot of time. Getting pretty close. To answer your question, thick guitars and furniture, yes, the first F5 mandolin that I made, I milled everything. Well, I actually got the wood that was already bookmatched. So I kind of got away with that part. I didn't have to mill any of that. But everything else was, yes, so I had a coping saw to do all the surrounding of the instrument. And then I just wanted to see how people were making instruments before they had any power tools and precision stuff. And I still have that mandolin. It's the one on my logo with all the inlay work. So in regards to the inlay work, I actually had a little Dremel base. So that's the that's the only power tool I use. But if I would have removed, if I would have been no inlay, the whole instrument would have been done without any power tools. Salut Hervé, comment ça va? Un bonjour de la France. Starting to look like a side. A little bit more down here. Be okay there. Technically, I don't want to cut myself too short, but this is where this is supposed to end. If I leave myself an extra inch, should have enough. For those who wonder why I'm going to cut it here at the center instead of getting it to go around where the point is, this piece, first of all, is too short. Because this piece always goes in behind the point and then ties up with the side in front of it. So for mandocello, I actually have to stop it right here, and then I'm gonna have a butt strip like I did on my first, so the video I just did on the mandocello. So yeah, So I'll be able to cut that up like right now, so I don't have to deal with that side anymore. Ça fait à peu près deux fois que je me brûle, donc c'est pas si pire. I always try just by feeling with my hands, I can feel if the wood still has some temperature to it or not. So if there's no temperature or if it doesn't feel warm enough, I always go back and kind of do a pass to warm up the fibers again, and then I can use more pressure without any or less risk of breaking. And by saying that, I'm probably gonna end up with a break now. I just jinxed it. This wood seems to have a lot of spring back as well. So I'm going to try to overbend a bit because it seems like it's having a hard time keeping it straight. Alright, so this is good here. This is where it's supposed to be. Okay. So that's where it actually works or break. Then I'm going to redo the scroll to make sure it fits. In the mold. But if it has to break, it's going to be right now.
Salut Sylvain, là, on a beaucoup de francophones sur ce feed-là. Was hot. Broke my clamp. Awesome. That's why you want to have good clamps. Going to use a different one, but now it's broken. I'll do it this way. I don't like to do it this way because it puts pressure
instead of, yeah. But I don't want to lose the shape of the scroll. That's good. Can't really go out to get another clamp, can I? This one is pretty much done. Shape that up a bit. So I'm going to put that one aside and let it dry. Yeah, but you fear breaking the clamp. Yeah, I'm gonna have to be more gentle with them now. So I had a kit of two of those, and now they're both broken. So I'm definitely not buying those ones again. Pretty disappointed. Although they lasted probably 8 years, so I don't know if it's the plastic that's getting kind of brittle as it ages, or I don't know. So now, so those ones are pretty straightforward. This, like I mentioned earlier, for this one, I have to get my other setup, the propane one. So I'm not gonna do that right now. So I've got one piece that needs to go all the way up to here. And I've got another piece that needs to tie up here. So those are pretty simple, like very, very mellow bends and stuff. And then with the time, what time is it right now? At 2:30, my wife and I are now sharing my tripod because she's a piano teacher. And being a piano teacher, she started doing online teaching. And because of that, she needs a tripod at this moment. So I want to thank you all for stopping by. Stay safe out there, stay busy. Have fun in your shop, do it safely, and I'll try to, whenever I can, to get you guys back in here. It was nice to kind of talk to people, even though like I'm kind of by myself, but like people are connecting through social media and the comment section, so I really appreciate that. And anyway, so until next time, I wish you well. Thanks for stopping by.